Hi, my loves. Welcome back to the Stars Cartel channel. If you don't know, I am Star. The message I heard is, what are you doing? The scripture comes from Obadiah 1 and 7. All your allies will force you to the border. Your friends will deceive you and overpower you. Those who eat your bread will set a trap for you, but you will not detect it. In that day, declares the Lord, will I not destroy the wise men of Edom, those of understanding in the mountains of Esau? Your warriors, seamen, will be terrified, and everyone in Esau's mountains will be cut down to the slaughter. Because of the violence against your brother Jacob, you will be covered with shame. You will be destroyed forever. On the day you stood aloof, while strangers carried off his wealth and foreigners entered his gates and cast lots for Jerusalem, you were like one of them. You should not gloat over your brother in the day of his misfortune, nor rejoice over the people of Judah in the day of their destruction, nor boast so much in the day of their trouble. So here's the message. So when God spoke this to me, it's kind of like, okay, so this is for someone, you were under attack, okay? So the what are you doing is for you, okay? You were under attack, and it was like someone was trying to send an attack to me, and this was, I'm not going to say who the person is, but like, I just feel like, this is an attack of someone trying to put you under some kind of spell, some kind of entrapment, some kind of trance. Regardless to if this is a lover or a counterfeit, this could be a counterfeit using witchcraft trying to put, how do I, like they're trying to make you want them. Okay, and you know, in witchcraft, this would be known as someone putting a love spell on somebody. Babe, y'all already know, you know what I'm saying? Y'all already know who I am. Okay, y'all know where I'm from. Y'all know that, you know, I just spoke about some of my family. How, you know, family in Louisiana and all that. And you know, and it's not to say that we into all that. But at the same time, I will say that there are videos you can look up on YouTube and find people talking about this here. And y'all already know that, you know, God saved me from doing things that I shouldn't have had my hand in. And I'm just saying that to say there are such things as love spells. There are certain different things that people can do to make you feel a way about them that you really don't feel, okay? And for someone, there may be someone that was doing this to you. This is someone that you are, in a sense, no longer attracted to, you no longer want them, you're no longer interested in them, and they may be very well trying to put this trance on you to gain your interest. Now, God says you have the power to fight this. Okay, there is no need for you to be caught up in this trance. There is no need for you to, and you know, once God spoke, what are you doing? Bam. Okay, like it was gone. And I'm sharing this with y'all so that you will, I just feel like this is for somebody. There's someone else. There's someone that you have, someone that is trying to put you in a trance. They are trying to catch you slipping. They trying to trap you, and they are using love spells to do so. Okay. They're like, regardless to what they using. Because there's so many things that they could use candles, they could use soaps, there are powders, oils. They could literally set up a little, like, have a little altar with you on it and just sit there. Like, baby, there's so many things that people could use now There are so many things that people could use to try to entrap you, to trap you in this way and have you in this trance where you don't even realize what's really going on. It's like, I just feel like this is someone that is trying to put a gloss over your eyes so that you cannot see who they really are. You already know who they are. God showed you. That's why you're not with them. That is why you are not with this person, because God showed you the truth. And once you were shown the truth, you can't get it out your mind. This person is trying to put this back on you so that you will go ahead and come on back. Because they won't you. Okay. Anyways, they feel as though they want you back, but you know who they are, and they are not who they see. It's like, I don't want to say who they perceive themselves to be, because in reality, they don't perceive themselves to be a certain way. It's who you perceive them to be. Because how this was working on whoever this is, you were seeing, when you would see this person, you did not see them for what they really were. You saw them as your dream person, or you saw them as somebody completely different. This is, I just feel like for somebody, you looked at this person after God removed that stuff from above you. God removed that from your eyes. I'm thinking about the scripture that I read. Let me see if I still have it pulled up. But this is full blown. Hold on. Dang, it's not there. Hold on, y'all. So this is John 9:1. I came into this world for judgment, so that those who do not see may see, and those who do see may become blind. Okay, so this is somebody you could not see. And because you could not see, God ensured that you could see. And once you were able to see, you could not unsee what you saw. And this is someone that is trying to make you blind again. But when you saw this person, when you were under whatever entrapments they had going on, and you know, it doesn't, the way that this stuff works, the love spell stuff works, they don't have to put it on you. They could just put it, this is somebody, they had it all over themselves. And I'm being reminded of how in Twilight, when the vampires stood into the light and they shined and they sparkled, and it's like they poured glitter, like they poured glitter all over themselves. And it's like, you were just drawn to them. That was the magic that they were using, that drawing you to them. And then once God removed this from your eyes, you were able to see they were nothing like what you thought. For some of you, you were scared when God revealed this person, who this person really was to you. And there may be times even when God is showing me, for somebody, it could be a situation where this person will use these spells on you from afar. So them doing this, they may have an altar with you up. They may have, you know, like all candles and all kind of stuff going on when they are away from you to make you feel drawn to them. And then when you see them, because God is not allowing you to go back to being blind, they don't look nothing like what you thought. It's like you went from excited to utter disgust. And you didn't know how to feel. But God said he is revealing this to you because he wants you to see this person for who they are. And he does not want you to end up entrapped in this nonsense again. And yeah, That's like, God is saying, what are you doing? You do not have to be in this. You have already overcame whoever this person is. It's no need for you to go back to being that person. I know for some of you, I just feel like you feel like because on one hand, it's kind of like you miss being with this person. You miss this person. You miss the fairy tale, okay? This was a fairy tale. This was land of make-believe when you were with this person. In your mind, you thought y'all had one thing going on, and it was not that. Like, I just feel like this is kind of like, I'm thinking of this movie that I didn't watch the movie. I watched somebody that did, like, what is it called when somebody does like a movie? They just kind of talk about the movie, a movie review or something like that. They basically explain the story. And in the movie, it was a woman that was blind and she didn't know what was going on around her. So what She was told that she was in a high rise and that she had all these neighbors that were interacting with her and that she had certain things going on. However, she actually started to realize that it wasn't what it really was. And I don't really remember the movie entirely. And, you know, this is probably on purpose so I can, you know, move on. But when she actually found out is that she was not where she thought she was. She wasn't in no high rise. She was in somebody's basement somewhere. The person that attacked her is actually the one that kidnapped her. He pretended that he was, not only was he the attacker, he was the ambulance people, the doctor, the lawyer. He was everybody, everybody, everybody. And he gave her a phone. She was trying to call, like, I think she had a brother or something like that and friends. And she's trying to call people, but the phone didn't work. And he was literally sitting there pretending as though he was all these people. He would change his voice around and she couldn't see. So she didn't know. But, you know, eventually I think everything was reversed. Her eyesight was fixed and she was able to go back to doing what she do. I think she was like an opera singer or something like that. And he was obsessed with her. But here's the thing. God is saying that, and that may very well, you know, this may be for somebody, you know, you got somebody that's obsessed with you. And you didn't know, you know, it, like, you know, sometimes people say that the person that it's good to be with somebody that loves you more than you love them. But this is not good because this is obsession and somebody loving you are two complete things. And I just feel like this person is kind of like not all the way good in my state. This is somebody that is trying to keep you captive. This is somebody that is not... They are not like, it's kind of like this mindset that a lot of men have today where they want a woman, they want a wife, they want a companion, but they are not willing to do things to in order to keep someone happy. And they are not thinking of you as you are a person with wants and needs. They think of you as an intimate object. And this is somebody that wants to, they just want to hold you like a, like kind of how, you know, like the flower, the rose from Beauty and the Beast, how the rose was in a glass. Like this is somebody that just, they just want to hold you and use you for whatever it is that they, their purposes, they feel such, they need to. They don't want anybody else to have you for one. But they are not, this is a situation where someone is just trying to have you. They just want to keep you. Like they want, I'm being reminded of how Casper kept telling the girl, the little girl that in that movie, can I keep you? Can I keep you? And she was like, what? You are not a toy, okay? You are not a toy now. And it's like this person in their mind, they're not, you know, completely understanding this. And, you know, even if, you know, in this relationship, okay, you were trying to do things to make yourself more comfortable, I just feel like this person did not want that, because they were happy with the way they were living, but they wanted to bring you into it. It's kind of like, I just feel like this is somebody that in their mind, you're a trophy, and they just brought you, they want to put you on a shelf, and that's that. It's not a situation. They don't see you as someone they are having a relationship with. They don't see you as someone that they are going to marry or did marry. They don't see you. They just as these things, like, they don't see you as who you really are. And I just feel like this is somebody that this person assumes certain things about you. Like, for some of you, this person may not have even realized who you really were, your personality. They don't even really know you very well. It's somebody that is just obsessed. They could possibly be just obsessed with how you look, obsessed with certain things about you. They have daydreamed and sat around and made up in their mind a perception of you. And they, once again, they see you as something that they want to have on a show. And it's kind of like I'm also being reminded, like, these shows and movies, but it's helping. Okay, I'm being reminded of Rick and Morty when Rick had people that he didn't want them to mess with him anymore. Like, people that he didn't want to be friends with, but he couldn't put it upon himself to take them up out of here. So he put them in some kind of goo that would make them believe that they were living the perfect life. So this is somebody that, and he basically had them up on a shelf in like this little storage place. So this is somebody that just want to put you up on a shelf, and they want you to think that you're living the perfect life and everything is sprinkles and sunflowers and rainbows, but it's not. Whew, that was baby. That was a lot, okay? And going back to the scripture, those who eat your bread and set a trap for you will set a trap for you, but you will not detect it. Your friends will deceive and overpower you. This is someone that made you believe that y'all were friends, but y'all are not friends. And it's not to say that, like, you know, it's not to say that this person has a hate towards you, but at the same time, it's a thin line. And while this person does not, it's like, this is just confusion. We already know the devil is the author of confusion, but this is confusion. This person sees you as an intimate object, like, and they are very frustrated and angry with the fact that you don't want to be an intimate object, and you are not a little, like, they want to sit you on a shelf like a jar or something like that. They feel as though you should just be okay with that. And for some of you, this is somebody that is very angry. They are dangerous. They are angry. And they don't like the fact that you are not willing to be this for them. They don't. And I'm like, baby, I'm not even, you know, but I just feel like this is somebody that is thinking of some very wicked things to do to you. I forgot what it's called when, like, this is some wicked stuff that this person is thinking of. Like, they have some very evil thoughts in their mind. For some of you, they want to take you up out of here and just hide you away. It's just like, literally what they're trying to do with this witchcraft is that it's just a different version. They want to take what you are, your essence, who you are, and push that back and just have you sitting still for something like a zombie. And it is very scary. But that is literally how this person is thinking in their mind. And for some of you, this is someone that may have been trying to get you on drugs, and they've been trying to get you hooked on stuff, and they've been trying, but they're doing this because they want you to be out of your mind. They want you to be out of your mind so they can treat you however they want and you can just accept whatever they got going on. And that, like, this is how this person is. And I think the most interesting thing about this is, even if they were to accomplish that task, they would eventually throw you away, because they would, it's like, this person is sick now. They would throw you away because they would feel like the objection, it's like you wouldn't be you anymore. And they wouldn't want you anymore. So this is somebody, like, y'all know how some kids, they ask for stuff and then they ask for it and they play with it for a while. It's their favorite thing. They beat it up. They drag it around. And then it's not what it was when you first got it for them. And now they don't want it no more. And they want something else. That's what this person got going. That's what they want to do. That is exactly what they want to do. They want to have you. You do exactly as they want. You use you up, beat you around, throw you around. You got all kind of stuff. Then when you not what you were when they found you, toss you out, they want something new. Whew. This is somebody that does not want you to be. For some of you, you had the knowing that something was going on, but you couldn't put your finger on it. For some of you, you may have been ripped away from this person. God himself ripped you away from this person, and then he revealed who they were to you, and it shook you. Long story short, God don't want you over there. God don't want you with this person, because obviously this person is like very sinister. This is somebody that has some very evil plans, okay? Very evil plans. This is somebody that is very wicked, and what they want to do for you is very wicked. What they want to do to you is very wicked. What they have in store. And, you know, this is a situation where God is saying you have the power to overcome this witchcraft that they are sending at you. You don't have to entertain this here. You have the power to overcome whatever it is that they are sending towards you. You already did it. That's why it didn't work out. You know, y'all are broken up because God has blessed you. God pulled you out of there. God pulled you away from this person because he does not want you to end up in this position. And, you know, for some of you, you cannot see it. You could not see it that this relationship was not what it was. It would have been a curse. You would have perished as who you are. You wouldn't be who you are anymore, who you are today, who you always have been. This is like somebody that just wanted you walking around out of your mind all day, every day. This is somebody that has some wicked plans, some sinister plans for you. And, you know, in reality, you know, this is like, okay, God said they don't deserve you. You don't deserve that. And God is seeking judgment upon it. God will deal with them. But this is one of those situations where God will kind of lift up his hand against somebody to get you out. And, you know, like, there were things that were going on while you were there. There were certain problems that this person has to deal with, but while you were with this person, they didn't have to deal with those problems because God eased his hand up on them because you were attached to them. But once God removed you, God said he got his hand right back on this person because of the evil that they're doing. This is somebody that is doing, because of your violence against your brother Jacob, you will be covered with shame. You will be destroyed forever. On the day you stood aloft while strangers carried off his wealth and foreigners entered his gates and cast lots for Jerusalem, you were like one of them. You should not gloat over your brother in the day of his misfortune, nor rejoice over the people of Judah in the day of their destruction, nor boast so much in the day of their trouble. This is somebody that intended to do all of this wickedness to you, and then gloat over the fact that you were no longer who you were, who they admired. That's why it says a thin line. With this person, it is a thin line. They adore you. They're obsessed with you, but they hate you for it. This is someone that hates you because they like you. You know how kids, when little boys like a little girl, and they'll be mean to her, but then they really like her deep down inside. Like, that's how this person was. That's how this person is. They like you, but they have menacing thoughts about you. And this could be somebody that has some things going on, some things that happened to them in their childhood. Sometimes when men were messed with when they were kids by other men, instead of their hatred going towards other men, their hatred will turn towards women. And it is so weird. I don't understand it. I don't get it. I don't know if it's because a woman allowed it to happen. Maybe there was a woman that knew that did not help them. But in reality, I just feel like this person has a hatred towards women. This is a man that hates women because look what he's doing. He falls in love with a woman. He's obsessed with her. He drags her through the mud, tears her down, gets her hooked on stuff, and then he disposes of her and he's chasing after somebody else. And this person is doing this on purpose over and over and over and over. And this may very well be somebody that is involved with trafficking. Okay, why do I say that? Because the scriptures say, and foreigners entered his gates and cast lots for Jerusalem. You were like one of them. So I just feel like this is someone that, let me read from the top. On the day you stood aloof while strangers carried off his wealth and foreigners entered his gates and cast lots for Jerusalem, you were like one of them. This is someone that wants to have someone completely defiled, completely destroyed, no longer being yourself, no longer being in your right mind, no longer knowing what day it is, let alone what year. You don't like this is somebody that is so evil and wicked. This is somebody that's so evil and wicked. They wicked, they wicked, they wicked. For some of you, this is somebody that is doing this for their friends' benefit as well. They have a knowing that this person is hopping around from person to person, and they're going to do the same thing. They're going to get the person hooked on all this stuff, and they're going to dispose of them, and then the friends will be able to do what they want to do. And this is somebody, like I said, this person is very heavy into witchcraft. This person is very obsessed. This is someone that has an obsession, and it jumps. And when they are obsessed with somebody, they, in their mind, they see this person as an object. They don't see this as a person. And, you know, this is very much giving slavery. Okay, I have to say it quietly, but, you know, that's what it's giving. Someone that looks at another person as an object, as a tool, as something that can be a possession. That's how they see you. And I know that sounds harsh, but I feel like whoever this message is for, you need to hear this. That's how they see you. You belong to them. You are theirs. You are theirs. You're something that can be paid for. You're something that can be bought and sold. And that's not what you are. And yeah. So whenever this person, whoever this is for, you know when this person is trying to put you under whatever spell and they trying to do this, that, and the third, you know, because you can feel it. But here's the thing. God says, what are you doing? You have the power to shut it down. You have the power to put an end to it. You have the power to overcome this. You have the power. And the enemy don't want you to know it. Because this person, whoever this person is, they definitely running all kind of stuff going on the enemy's team. But God said his foot is upon thy neck. The things that you may remember that were blessings. God gave you so many blessings, because, and it was for you. This person was able to benefit off of these blessings. That ain't going on no more. Whatever blessings that God had in store for you, the blessings that God allowed you to receive, this person cannot receive these things. This was because God wanted you to have these things. It ain't had nothing to do with them. In reality, God foot been on their neck for the other people. They've been doing this over and over and over again. There are other victims of this. Baby, but God said he does not want you to fall for this. This is not your portion. It's not your portion. And, you know, like I said, this is somebody, in reality, you wouldn't even be attracted to this person if it wasn't for them putting all this love spell and this magic and this witchcraft that they throwing at you. It makes you want, it makes you see them differently than what they actually are. But in reality, this person is not attractive to you. They heavy on all these drugs and stuff that they get people hooked on. They using it too. They don't look the way that you saw them when you were under their spell. They don't act that way either. Nor do they have the things that you, when you were under the spell, you thought they had it going on. And they big boss and they big baby. It's not really what you thought it was. This is somebody you were under a spell and you was gone. But this person, this somebody, they ain't even attractive like that. They not attractive like that. This is somebody that's not even, they do the same thing over and over and over again. And it's not meant, it's not intended for you to end up in the trap that they set for women over and over and over and over again. And as sad as this is, you know, that's the truth. And I know it may feel like, well, then who is for me? And when is God going to send me my somebody? Like, I truly feel like there's someone that you just would like to go back and be under this person's spell. But you don't want it. I'm telling you, it looks good. It sounds good. But don't play with God, okay? Just as the devil was standing there trying to tempt Jesus, telling him if he throw himself off the cliff, he'll be fine. And if he go ahead and test God, he will do this, that, and the third. God said, do not test God. Do not test God. God already saved you. Why would you run back to what God saved you from? Just because you cannot visually see what God has in store for you in the future. Just because this person specifically is not there does not mean that there's nothing, okay? You, like, it's men everywhere. It's women everywhere, okay? And I truly feel like this is more so for a woman than a man. But it's, you know, it's men everywhere. Why do you just gotta have that one? They not even what you thought. They don't look anything like what you thought. They don't have what that you thought they had going on. They don't have that going on. Why? What's going on? What is going on? Once again, what are you doing? That's the message. God got better for you. Ain't no need to be hooked on whoever this nutcase is. Okay, let them go. Let that clown go. Thank you guys for watching. Be sure to like, share, and subscribe. Deuces.